Welcome, my fellow game devs. Today, we are going to make a spline train in Unity using the physics engine. If you've already looked into making splines, you've likely seen most people animating the position of an object along the path of a spline by using a fractional t value to determine where on the spline the object should be, then incrementing t by the progression of game time to make it look like it is moving uniformly along the path. This is a fine way to do it, but there are two problems here for what I want in my game. First, I want to control the train's speed. Now this could be done using the time-based solution, but I'm not really interested in doing the math for slowing down and speeding up time based on the changing speeds of the train. I also want the size of the train to change how heavy it feels, which would add a lot of complexity here. Second, and more importantly, I want the train carts behind the engine to have the delayed start as each link between the carts tighten. I don't see an easy way to do this using the time variable on the spline. Making the spline itself is pretty straightforward once you have the built-in Unity Spline package installed. I should note here that I think this package requires Unity 2022.1 or higher, so if you're working with a previous version, you'll probably want to find a different spline package. But as long as there's a way for you to get the closest point on your spline line, you should be able to accomplish the same thing. The first thing I recommend doing is getting familiar with the spline package you are using. I don't even want to tell you how much time it took me to realize the object holding the spline component needed to be referred to as the spline container in my scripts. It was very unintuitive based on how the rest of Unity works. And that leads me to the first thing you need to do to get this going, adding a spline component to a game object to start putting a path together. If it's installed correctly, and you're using the Unity package, you should be able to right-click the hierarchy, hover over the 3D object, then hover over spline, and then click Draw Spline Tool, and this will create a new object with a spline component in it. This does the same thing as adding a spline component to an empty object if you prefer to do that. From here, you can add as many points as you want by clicking the spline edit mode, which is a little button right by the pan tool in scene view. You can make it a closed loop or open path, and you can move the points to make it a linear 2D or 3D path. For my purposes, I want a top-down 2D perspective, so all the Y values will be set to 0 for my spline. Once you have a spline to work with, you'll want to add an object to follow the path. If you're just animating the object along the path like most people, the package has an easy-to-use built-in component called Spline Animate, which you would add to the object that is meant to follow the path. Unfortunately, this is not what we want to do here. I was desperate to try and make a hybrid thing work for a little while because I couldn't find any other solutions. But after about a full day of failed attempts, I decided to move on and just model my own physics object. The most obvious thing I needed to do to get this started is to make the object snap to the closest part of the path. Fortunately, after playing around with the built-in examples, I knew that they already had some code written to do this. So I just took some snippets from there and made a new script for my own object. After an embarrassingly long time of not realizing the getNearestPoint utility function returned a local vector and not a global vector, I had a working script that snapped my object to the closest point on the path, plus some bonus points for making it point in the tangent direction of the path. Don't ask me to explain much about this code. Now with that out of the way, it's time to figure out the physics part. Fortunately, I came across a Reddit post that saved me hours of headache. The gist of what needs to be done here is position the object on the path with it pointing forwards along the tangent, but also making sure this is applied to the transform of the object instead of the rigid body. The physics part comes in by applying forward or backward force when desired, since the object should now always be facing forward in relation to the spline, then redirecting the velocity vector of the rigid body to face the forward direction so it doesn't lose velocity when it's turning along the spline path. Okay, that was a lot of explanation, but what does that look like? After forcing the transform onto the spline, the rest of the code is very straightforward. All I need to do is reassign the velocity vector to the forward direction, which can simply be done by multiplying the length of the vector by the current forward vector. This works because the forward vector is always pointing in the direction I want the object to go, and it always has a length of 1, so scaling this by the current length of velocity allows it to keep moving along the path without losing speed. You can also see a dot product calculation going on, which checks to see if the object is reversing directions in the current frame, and allows this to happen properly. And finally, I added some code to apply force when pressing a button to test it out. Big shout out to iFrezzy for leading me to this solution. Now that I have the basic model set up, I need to turn this into an actual train, so it's time to model some cars to attach to each other. To try this out, all I'm doing is adding some links to the back of the engine and the front and the back of each cart using some rescaled cubes so that they link up like a chain while having some dead space within the links. This is to try and get that delayed start effect from each cart. Once this is done, all I need to do is attach the script to each cart and line them up along the spline so that they are connected on play. I also made sure only the front car has force being applied to it, to confirm that each cart responds properly to being pulled by a cart in front of it. Amazingly, this all worked almost flawlessly right off the bat. I only had a small issue with overriding a function when I was making the engine script separate from the car movement script, but once that was sorted out, it worked pretty much exactly the way I wanted. And that's pretty much it for making a spline train that reacts to physics. Next thing would be to make the carts spawn aligned with each other instead of having to link each one by hand every time, but that's something for another time. For now, you can just watch me mindlessly making the train accelerate and decelerate in my state of exhaustion and relief after finally figuring this all out.